And we've talked about this this concept of Tom Brady getting together with teammates and working out. And now, because everything's starting to open up again, you know, look, the rules aren't what they were back in March when we saw right. players like Dak Prescott and Dez Bryant out and about when everyone was supposed to be locked down. And, you know, they're all touching the same football and they're taking pictures hanging all over each other. That was jarring at the time, although – even then, there were people who were like, oh, that's fine. That's not an issue. Well, yeah, it is an issue. Now it's not an issue, although people still need to be careful about, you know, staying 6 feet apart and their hygiene, et cetera. But you've got these guys who are out practicing football, getting ready. Chris, the NFL has no issue with it. And I wasn't surprised by the report from Rick Stroud of the Tampa Bay Times that the NFL has no issue with Tom Brady and his teammates working out. They didn't have any issue with Dez Bryant and Dak Prescott doing it back in March. They weren't going to punish anyone for this, even though it's probably something that, yeah, they shouldn't be condoning and they should be a little more aggressive about. Now that things are opening up again, what are you going to do? And that's the disconnect. You can't go work out at the facility because they're not letting the players back at any facility until all facilities can be open throughout the NFL. But you can, in theory, go to a park on the other side of the facility wall and have at it in an organized practice with your teammates.
Well, yeah, and that's what I would be doing. I know that. You know, again, we had this conversation last week. I mean, first off, how the hell is the NFL going to tell some 43-year-old man what kind of work and what they can and can't do anyways? I mean, that's just ludicrous to me. Oh, you want to get better at your profession? How dare you do that? But, like the thing that jumps out to me more than any of this is here's the Tom Brady effect. We're seeing it right away. I mean, I don't know, Mike. You see any other teams or quarterbacks having practice right now? Nobody else is showing me. Not like that. I mean, Tom Brady's wearing his damn shoulder pads and got his helmet on, and he's organizing.
Time out. Yeah. Time out. I understand that these guys are allowed to go out and do their own thing. How in the hell are they getting Buccaneers helmets? I mean, isn't there just a line somewhere there that maybe you're crossing if the team is supplying the helmets? I mean, it's an easy exception. Well, we can't allow you into the facility to practice, but here's all your gear. Go ahead and practice in that field over there.
Well, yeah. I mean, first off, they know what gear he needs, right? So they can very easily have just dropped a bag off of all the equipment, knowing what size helmet he has, the shoulder pads he wears and all that, and just leave it at his front door. So I'm not trying to say anything like that, but I mean, you're right. But other than that, though,
it's an obvious loophole, and every team could be doing it and maybe should be doing it. If the Buccaneers are doing it, why isn't everybody doing it? I guess that's my point.
That's what I'm saying. Why is the 43-year-old guy who's already accomplished more than everybody in the league altogether combined the one leading practices? Let's go, NFL quarterbacks. Let's go. I mean, this is the greatness of Brady. Here he is. He's having reps, conversations about the offense. He's learning the offense, and he's conquering swamp ass. And that's a great thing because it's gonna be real, Mike. You know, as we've talked about, my poor center down there in Tampa, John Wade, I know he used to get so frustrated. But, you know, like you talked about, in Tampa, it's 90, 95, 98 degrees. The humidity will be 90%. You know, the center, the offensive linemen are drenched in sweat. You take a snap and it's like getting a wet watermelon in your hand all the time. You know, but so I used to make the center change his pants. I really like this trick by Brady. I wish I would have known that. First off, it gives you a little cushion there in between, you know, the nether regions, and just there's a towel in between your hands. But obviously that's going to have some effect on not having the center's butt that wet. I hope they're using organic baby powder. But other than that, I wish I knew that idea. That's why he's the GOAT. He's got all the ideas figured out.
Yeah, and Cameron Brate, who will be working with Brady on the Buccaneers, he says it's a little weird to be working with Brady, teaching him the offense. We're teaching him the verbiage. It's kind of backward way of how it's probably going to progress during the season, with him kind of teaching us about his game and how he sees things. But look, this is the value, as you said, of having a guy like Tom Brady, who's basically a coach on the field, a guy who is going to – when you get the call from Tom Brady – now think about it. If you are a second-year guy, if you're – and Kyler Murray accomplished enough that maybe his guys will respond to him. If you're Daniel Jones, and you're calling up all these guys on the Giants and you're like, hey, we're going to get together at the local high school and we're going to work out. You know, I don't know what the attendance rate's going to be, but if it's Tom Brady, it's going to be 100% plus. There's going to be guys there that aren't even on the team. Let's go. We're ready, man. Tom Brady's saying you show up. So I guess yes. It's easier for him, but at the same time, I'm amazed, like you said, that other teams aren't doing this. And this is another reason to think that when the regular season ends, one of the teams left standing for the postseason is going to be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. We're already seeing it play out.
No doubt. Mike, I think what you're going to see, really, we're going to see certain players who really thrive this year. The players who really love football and the players who love to work at their craft, you know, I think you're going to see them separate themselves this year in a season like this. Because, you know, as you know and I know, there's a number of players who, yeah, they play football and they work hard, but they're not going to go like above and beyond unless they're at the facility and they're being coached or the trainer's telling them to do things. You certainly have a faction of players like that. But the players that are self-motivated and want to be great, the Bradys, the Michael Thomases of the world, I bet you they're going to come into training camp full systems go. Here we go. And so I really think there is going to be an advantage to that. And I would think, yes, other quarterbacks out there, they got to get this going. You know, this would be the approach for me. I would be, if I was a head coach, I would be sending Tom Brady, you know, here's 30 plays through email. Try to run those at practice today with the guys. Go through it, have them, you know, have some dialogue, have some talk. It's got to be really weird too, Mike, right? Like Cameron Brate teaching Tom Brady something. It'd be like me and you teaching Mike Tirico about TV. It just doesn't seem right. But either way, it's pretty cool that Brady's already getting so indoctrinated with his teammates.
And here's the thing. How much of it is Brady learning the offense? Because it's not just – because Brady isn't completely submitting. He's going to have his own twist. He's going to have his own take. But before he can get to the point where he applies his own take, he has to learn what they're doing. It's like you have to learn exactly what they're doing before you start making changes. So he does have to learn from them, and then they learn from him once he applies his twist to whatever the Buccaneers are doing offensively.
That's right. He's got to learn the language first to speak with them, right? I mean, and that's the language of the offense. And I would think there's some similarities in the language. Bruce Arians, you know, his Pittsburgh days, that was a Giants offense of system from the days of when my dad played. And, of course, New England ran that similar system too. So I would think there are some similarities. But you're right, Mike. You know, Brady's got to learn the way they've been taught nuances of the offense first and their language and just speak it with them. And then he'll be able to bring, you know, his wise wisdom to those guys and go, okay, I know you guys do it this way, but Belichick, I, and McDaniels used to do it this way. And I think it really will give you a great advantage to get open Cameron Brate when you run a deep cross or whatever it may be. And I think that's where they'll start to go, oh my gosh, Brady is really special. I never thought about running this route, you know, this way versus this coverage. And then, oh, it's a different coverage and I'm going to make this little tweak. And those are little nuances that Brady and New England are above and beyond the rest of football. And I think that it will show in Tampa, let alone all this great work they're doing already down there.
Yeah, even though Tom Brady isn't like Peyton Manning from the perspective of coming in and taking over the entire offense, Brady knows his place. I think what Brady's going to realize is there's a hell of a lot he can contribute to what they're already doing to make it better based upon 20 years of being with the best franchise statistically and based on championships in the NFL since 2000. All right, one more quick one before we break. Rob Gronkowski, he says that he is getting closer and closer to his playing weight. I'm about 257 right now. Everyone thinks I'm like 240, 230, but I'm basically four more protein shakes away from being at my playing weight. I'll be at 260 to 265 when it's time to roll. And we had always thought it wouldn't be all that hard for him to put his weight back on. It would have been more of a challenge during football season. He's got the full off season to get himself to where he needs to be. He'll be there by the time September rolls around. Chris, nobody has any doubt about that.
No doubt about that. I mean, he might be there by the end of Memorial Day weekend. You know, you have a few beers and eat some burgers and some hot dogs, and he'll be pushing 260, no doubt about it. So, yeah, there's plenty of time, and I'm sure he's starting to get in the weight room more and more and lift heavier and heavier weights. And, you know, he does, like when the picture I saw of him on social media, it doesn't look like it's 256 or 257, but I will say, seeing him in person, he's a lot longer and taller than you would think as compared to being thick and like, you know, how we envision most football players, just like, oh my gosh, they're so dense and so muscular. You know, again, Gronkowski's, he's right around 6'7" or just a little below it. And, you know, when you're 265 pounds at 6'7", you don't look like, you know, you're a thick, muscled up guy that way anyways. But he's a monster and he loves it. And I think that's not even going to be an issue. 265 by the time the season rolls around.
Yeah, I mean, especially heading into a holiday weekend, wouldn't we all love to carry that burden of having to gain weight?
Right.
I would love at some point in my life to somebody say to me, you must gain 15 pounds. Sign me up for that. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. You know, we think you're looking a little thin on the air. You probably should gain 15 pounds. Okay. I'll have that done by Monday, sir. Thank you. I can do 15 more if you would like as well. Just say the word.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.